Well, the animations of yesteryear being featured for their cultural significance at a new exhibit. Tracy Strahan has more in this morning's Positively Black.
News for New York presents Positively Black.
The revolution was televised when it came to the animated portrayals of African Americans, from Valerie from Josie and the Pussycats to, of course, Fat Albert, who we just saw there. Some of the most beloved cartoons from the 70s are being heralded for their impact on black culture. It's all through a new exhibit called Funky Turns 40. It's on display at the Schomburg Center for Research in Black Culture. And Pamela Thomas, the curator, I'm so happy you're here because I grew up on Saturday morning cartoons, didn't we all?
Yes, we did, and thank you for having me.
Well, so let's talk about some of the images that are included in all of this. We saw Fat Albert, of course, we all love him. Or who else do we see here?
We have Billy Joe Jive. we have Josie and the Pussycats, Valerie Brown. Verb.
Yes.
We have a number of
Bebe's
characters.
Bebe's Kids even, too.
Yes, included. Bebe's Kids, one of our favorites.
Well, it's interesting because I'm wondering, you say Funky Turns 40. Yes. Is the title of the exhibit. Where does the 40 come in?
Well, a lot of the cartoons is coming up on their 40th anniversary since they first aired on television. So we decided that we wanted to celebrate these cartoons because for a generation of children, it changed their lives to see characters that looked like them on television.
I wanted to talk about the impact here. We even see in the Brown Hornet, of course, and just all of the great cartoons. You don't think about cartoons and culture going hand in hand. So I'm wondering how people are receiving this when they come to the Schomburg Center.
It's being received very well. It's bringing back a lot of memories for people. They're bringing their children and their grandchildren, and they're telling their stories about how these cartoons were revolutionary for them, coming out of the 60s, going into the Black Power movement of the 70s. And it was really the first time that these images were seen on television in a positive view.
Now, I was going to say, we look back on this with nostalgia, you know, on all of the memories, but how was it received at the time, back in the early 70s and 60s, when people were surprised to see these type of things? Some of them today may be perceived as stereotypes even.
Yes, they were. However, if you were growing up in the 60s and you saw the images of what was taking place during the riots, the civil rights movement, and people fighting for equality, this was really the first time that children got to see themselves in a positive light on in cartoons. Because a number of the cartoons from the 1960s going back, blacks were portrayed in a negative stereotype. We had elongated faces, bulging eyes, protruding lips. So now this was really the first time that we saw images that looked like ourselves and told stories about what a lot of young children were experiencing at the time.
Let's talk about the now. The era of Saturday morning cartoons has changed a little bit. Safe to say that what we're seeing in this exhibit had an impact on what we're seeing now?
Absolutely. I think there are more positive cartoons that are out currently today.
Right.
They're more integrated. You have characters of different ethnic backgrounds playing and enjoying each other's company, so it has had a positive impact.
Well, the exhibit is called Funky Turns 40, on display at the Schomburg Center through June. For more on their website, you got to head to that uncutfunk.com. Pamela, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
This has been a public affairs presentation from NBC4 New York, Positively Black.